Hey there, it's CJ with Smoky Beginnings. Ready to elevate your smoking game? Good, because today we're using the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker to create the juiciest, most tender, whole smoked chicken you've ever tasted. Whether you're a seasoned pit master or a novice, this guy will help you achieve chicken perfection. In this video, I'll walk you through every step of the process, like selecting the right chicken, pairing a delicious brine, creating the perfect rub, mastering temperature control, and achieving the perfect smoky flavor. And of course, I'll be sharing tips and tricks along the way. So if you're ready to get this party started, then let's go. But before we get going, let's address the elephant in the room. Smoking chicken can be tricky, often resulting in dry, rubbery meat lacking deep smoky flavor. But with the right technique and your Masterbuilt electric smoker, you'll serve up perfectly smoked chicken every time. And let me paint you a picture. Imagine pulling a golden brown chicken from your smoker. Its skin is crispy and glistening. As you cut into it, juices flow freely and the aroma of smoky goodness fills the air. Meat is tender, succulent, with a perfect balance of seasoning and smoke. You're in luck, because today that is our goal and that's what we're going to get. Let's dive into the process of creating that perfect smoked chicken by starting with how to choose your chicken. For the best results, opt for a whole chicken weighing between 3 to 5 pounds. Look for organic or free-range chickens if possible, as they tend to have a better flavor. If you prefer, you can also use chicken parts like legs, thighs, or wings. Just keep in mind that the cooking times will vary. For most smokers and brining purposes, I found that a whole chicken weighing between 3 to 5 pounds is ideal size. This range provides the perfect balance of even cooking and flavor absorption. Speaking of brine, let's talk about the process. Before we do, I wanted to let you know that I have a whole video dedicated to smoking a whole chicken on the pit barrel cooker, just a charcoal smoker. Stay tuned until the end of this video for a link to that video. And while I have you here, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Not only are you letting me know that you like this content, you're playing an integral part in helping the channel grow. Now, don't skip the brining when preparing smoked chicken. It's a key for boosting juiciness and flavor. This process involves soaking the chicken in a saltwater solution, often with added herbs and spices, for several hours before smoking. Brine works by allowing the meat to absorb moisture and seasoning, resulting in a more succulent and flavorful end product. Not only does brining help prevent the chicken from drying out during the long smoking process, but it also seasons the meat from the inside out, ensuring that every bite is packed with delicious flavor. And here's the simplest brine recipe that you will ever see. We will need 1 gallon of cold water and 3/4 cup of lemon pepper seasoning. Mix all the ingredients until the lemon pepper seasoning has dissolved, submerge your chicken in the brine, and refrigerate for at least 4 hours or overnight for best results. See? Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. After the brining process is complete, it's time to prepare your chicken for the smoker. This step helps create chicken with juicy meat and crispy skin. Carefully remove the chicken from your brine solution. Be gentle to avoid tearing the skin, which is now softer than a baby's butt. Some pit masters prefer to give the chicken a quick rinse under cold water to remove excess salt. This step is optional, but can help if you're concerned about over-salting. My preferred method is using paper towels to pat the chicken dry. Moisture on the surface of the skin will create steam in the smoker, preventing that desirable crispiness. Be sure to pat both the outside and the inside of the chicken, paying extra attention to crevices like the area between the wings and the body. Let the chicken continue to air dry by letting it sit at room temperature for about 30 minutes. This step serves two purposes. It allows any remaining surface moisture to evaporate, further promoting crispy skin. It brings the chicken closer to room temperature, which will help it cook more evenly in the smoker. A little food safety note here, don't leave the chicken at room temperature for more than 2 hours to prevent bacterial growth. If you need more time, place it in the refrigerator and remove it 30 minutes before smoking. By following these steps, you're setting the stage for perfectly smoked chicken with juicy meat and that coveted crispy skin. The extra attention to detail at this stage will pay off in your final product. While the chicken is air drying, let's prepare the dry rub. Today, we're keeping it simple by using the same lemon pepper seasoning from our brine. It is a quick and easy option that still delivers great flavor. Those who prefer homemade rub, here's a well-balanced recipe. 2 tablespoons of paprika, 1 tablespoon garlic powder, 1 tablespoon onion powder, 1 teaspoon dried thyme, 1 teaspoon dried rosemary, 1 teaspoon black pepper, 1 teaspoon salt. Mix all the ingredients thoroughly. Whether you're using the lemon pepper or this homemade blend, apply the rub generously to the chicken, making sure to get under the skin for maximum flavor. A little side note here, if you're using the homemade rub, consider incorporating it into your brine instead of the lemon pepper seasoning for a consistent flavor profile throughout the process. All right, let's move on to setting up the Masterbuilt electric smoker. Start by preheating your smoker to 225 degrees Fahrenheit. This low and slow approach is ideal for achieving tender, juicy skin. While your smoker is heating up, let's discuss the importance of wood chips and how to select the right ones. The type of wood chips chips you use can significantly impact the flavor of your smoked chicken. For poultry, modern woods like apple, cherry, or pecan are excellent choices. These woods impart a subtle, sweet smoke that complements the chicken without overpowering it. Avoid stronger woods like mesquite, which can be too intense for chicken. Today, I'll be using a mix of hickory and applewood. Once you choose your wood chips, add them to the smoker's chip tray. For the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker, you don't need to soak the chips beforehand. Simply fill the chip tray with about a cup of wood chips. You'll need to add more chips every 30 to 45 minutes during the first few hours of smoking to maintain a consistent smoke level. Place a water pan filled with hot water or apple juice on the bottom rack of the smoker. The water pan helps maintain moisture inside the smoker. With the smoker preheated and wood chips produce the smoke, it's time to begin. Place your chicken on the middle rack for optimal heat circulation. Now, the waiting game begins. Expect to smoke a whole bird for about 3 to 4 hours or 1 to 2 hours for parts. This is where the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker shines, and it's perfect for beginners. It is a smoker that is very well insulated and maintains temperature with relative ease. You don't have to add more pellets or make sure that your propane tank is full or add more wood or charcoal. All you have to do is turn the smoker on and set your cooking temp. When it comes to monitoring the internal temperature of the chicken, consider meat probe, like my trusty Meter Plus meat probe. I have a link in the description, into the thickest part of the breast, avoiding the breastbone. Some models of the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker come with a built-in temperature probe and temperature alarm. If your smoker has one, set the alarm to 165 degrees Fahrenheit, the safe internal temperature for chicken. While the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker is designed for easy temperature maintenance, it's still wise to check periodically. So we're going to check in every hour or two to see how the bark is forming and if the seasoning is adhering to the skin. Just make sure to avoid opening the door too often to prevent temperature fluctuations, which will extend your cooking times. For extra juiciness and flavor, consider basting your chicken hourly with a mixture of apple juice and melted butter. Use a spray bottle for even application. However, keep in mind that basting may make it harder to achieve a crispy skin. When it comes to checking for doneness, use your meat thermometer to check the internal temperature of the thickest part of the breast. Make sure that it has reached 165 degrees Fahrenheit internally. As a way of double checking your temperature reading, check the temperature in a few different spots, including the thickest part of the thigh. This helps ensure the entire chicken is evenly cooked. Thighs should also reach 165 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's talk about carryover cooking. Keep in mind that carryover cooking will continue to raise the temperature slightly after you remove the chicken from the smoker. This means that even if the thermometer reads slightly below 165 degrees Fahrenheit, when you take it out, it will likely reach that safe temperature as it rests. In addition to temperature, there are visual and textural cues to check for doneness. The juices should run clear when you cut into the chicken, and the meat should no longer be pink. The skin should be golden brown and crispy. After confirming the chicken has reached the desired internal temperature, remove it from the smoker and let it rest for 10 to 15 minutes. Resting allows the juices to redistribute throughout the meat, making it more flavorful and easier to carve. Speaking of which, it is now time to carve this baby up. When carving the chicken, I prefer to leave the legs and the wings whole, so I'll remove them first. Next, I'll take off the entire breast and then slice it into smaller sections. I may even hand shred it depending on how I'm feeling that day. For presentation, I'll leave the meat on this cutting board because I have to admit, I'm a bit proud of this cutting board. I just made it the other day and I'm in love with it. Don't forget to save those bones as you use them to make chicken stock. That is a bajillion times better than anything that you will find in a supermarket. And there you have it, a whole chicken smoked to perfection on the Masterbuilt Electric Smoker. This chicken turned out incredibly juicy and tender. With meat that falls off the bone, there wasn't a single dry or rubbery piece to be found. Now it's your turn to put this knowledge into action. Fire up your Masterbuilt, grab a chicken, and start your smoking journey. Don't forget to share your results in the comments below. I'd love to see your smoky creations. I've left some additional tips for smoking chicken in the comments. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more smoking tips and tricks. And if you want more recipes for chicken, ribs, burgers, steaks, and much more, then check out the playlist at the end, which is all about charcoal grilling and smoking. For more jewel-worthy recipes, visit smokybeginnings.com. I left a link in the description. I've also included a link below where you can support my channel and fuel my caffeine addiction. Until next time, keep those fires burning and those taste buds tingling. Have a good one.